Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2009, Pivot Slicers. Hey, I'm podcasting this whole book. Go ahead and subscribe. Use that I in the top right-hand corner. Welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Yesterday, we built this pivot chart, and today I want to talk about another great feature of pivot tables called slicers. Before we talk about slicers, we should talk about the old way, and that's the filter. All right, so you had a pivot table. You could filter maybe by name and region would make sense to be first. These worked, but the filter has to live next to the pivot table, and the thing I really hated is when you select multiple items, it doesn't print on the report. So now I have multiple items selected, but no one, you know, if I print this out, no one will have any clue which multiple items. Yuck. All right, so Excel 2010 brought us a great new feature called a slicer. Alright, so I'm going to come back up here to where my dashboard is going to be. Analyze tab, I'm going to insert a slicer, and I want a slicer for region and for name. Click OK. Alright, now by default, they are always tiled right here in the middle of the screen. I always move them and rearrange them. Alright, so region has two choices, east and west. It can easily be two columns like this, doesn't have to be as tall. And we'll change the color for region. We'll make it fit right there. Okay, and then name. Well, I guess I only have five. I'm just going to let that live right there. I don't want it to be so big I get a scroll bar. All right, and the way that it works now is if I want to see this report for just east, I click east, or just west, or everything. And then I could choose one sales rep. I could control click multiple sales reps. In Excel 2016, they gave us the multi-select. That lets me touch without having to hold down control. Great for a touch screen, by the way. All right, so these visual filters, they're much, much better than the old report filters. You can use them with pivot charts, or you can use them with pivot tables. Now, tomorrow, we're going to add a second pivot chart, and then the day after that, I'll show you how to hook these slicers up to multiple pivot tables, pivot charts. Great, great dashboarding trick. All right, hey, please go out, buy the book. It has everything we're talking about in August and September in the podcast here. Great way to impress your boss. So recap, pivot filters have been around for a long time. They always live near the pivot table. They're awful when you want to select multiple items with that multiple items tag. So in Excel 2010, they introduced slicers. They do the same thing. They're visual filters. When you insert multiple, they're always tiled in the middle of the screen, but you change the number of columns, change the size, change the colors, and they work great, great for multi-select. All right, so I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you tomorrow, where we'll continue this series on building a dashboard.